Hi, I'm Joy Lawrence. Welcome to my logical fallacies video. In this video, I will go over what the logical fallacies are and why you want to avoid them. I'll also provide you with examples of many different types of logical fallacies. Logical fallacies are flawed logic. They're reasoning errors that'll undermine your argument. In a logical fallacy, there's something missing between the claim and the evidence of your argument, much like this person's head in the picture. You want to avoid using logical fallacies because they'll keep you from effectively proving your argument. You want to avoid using sources that include logical fallacies because their logic is flawed and therefore they're untrustworthy sources. All logical fallacies are a type of non sequitur, which is Latin for it doesn't follow. I bet you didn't know you were getting a Latin lesson today. With a non sequitur, the conclusion is not a logical result of the facts. For example, this argument that Jenny should marry Mateo because he got all A's in college breaks down when we analyze it more. What does getting good grades have to do with being a good life partner? Nothing. The evidence does not help prove the argument. A hasty generalization is when we base an argument on too few examples or unrepresentative evidence. For example, many of us have heard the argument that pit bulls are dangerous, vicious monsters. But what's the actual evidence of this? How many examples do we really have? How many examples are out there that show pit bulls to be happy, goofy love bugs? We have a tendency to make assumptions based on patterns we've observed. That's human nature. But we have to be careful to avoid this tendency when making logical arguments. Instead, we want to look for evidence that helps to prove a reasoned argument. The either-or fallacy is when you're presented with only two options when you know that more exist. Say that you're told you can eat either an unhealthy meal of a burger and fries, or you can have an apple and a glass of water. Really? These are my only two options? There's not something somewhere in between? Can't I make a healthy version of that burger? Can't I have some kind of protein with that apple? You want to avoid giving readers two options when they know more options are out there. Making this kind of argument makes readers question the author's credibility, and you don't want to lose that ethos. Argument ad hominem means against the man. More Latin! Yay! This is when a person's character is attacked instead of their argument. For example, let's say we want to attack the character of a family counselor. We might say, "Why should we listen to what Dr. Bennett says? She's been divorced twice. How good can her marriage advice be?" We've just attacked Dr. Bennett's character, but we know nothing about her abilities as a marriage counselor. Maybe those failed marriages have given her insight into what makes a marriage successful. Maybe those failed marriages had nothing to do with her knowledge about successful marriages. You want to be suspicious when someone attacks a person's character instead of their argument, and you want to avoid doing it in your own arguments. The bandwagon fallacy insinuates that you should join the crowd. Everyone else is doing it. Don't you want to fit in? We see examples of this fallacy all the time in advertisements, like with beer commercials. Everyone's at the party and having a great time. We need to be careful when someone's arguing that everyone else is doing something, so we should jump on the bandwagon too. Post hoc ergo propter hoc is Latin for after this, therefore, because of this. I promise, this is the last bit of Latin I'll throw at you in this video. The post hoc ergo propter hoc fallacy insinuates a causality, meaning one event causes another. It's easier to understand this fallacy if you think of it as the superstition fallacy. I'm having bad luck because that black cat crossed my path, or the mirror broke, or I walked under that ladder. Or it's raining today because I just washed my car yesterday. Okay, if we had that kind of power, we'd all be out washing our cars to bring more rain to California. Sometimes there is a causal link between events, but you want to make sure that link actually exists. Otherwise, it's a fallacy. Begging the question is when someone tries to prove an argument by repeating a statement. Why is Benny a good boy? Well, because he's a good boy, of course. Well, Benny definitely is a very good boy. I can prove that by providing better details. He's very well trained, knows how to do obstacle courses, and always comes when he's called. In fact, he's sleeping by my feet right now while I'm making this video. Those are all better pieces of evidence that prove Benny is a good boy. Another form of begging the question is repeating the statement in different words. A student might argue that they can't have received an F on a test because they're an A student. Now, that student very well may have earned A's on most other tests, but that is not proof that an F on one test is inconceivable. The name for the red herring fallacy comes from the practice of someone dragging a red herring across their path while running from police to try to throw the dogs off the scent. That's exactly what's being done with the red herring fallacy. The reader is being thrown off the scent, and the writer is avoiding the full argument and any opposition to it. One easy way to understand the red herring fallacy is to think of it in terms of relationships. For example, say you come home late one night. Your partner's already mad at you when you walk in the door and starts arguing right away. Where have you been? Why didn't you call? I've been worried sick. I had no idea where you were. You don't like this reception, so you reach into your arsenal and grab onto the first thing you find. You notice the kitchen is a mess and you ask, "What's with these dirty dishes? It was your turn to clean the kitchen. You know we have a problem with ants, and I can see them lining up again right now. Great." Then your partner starts apologizing. "I'm sorry, it's just the kids were so crazy, I couldn't get to it." Awesome. Now, instead of having to defend yourself, you have your partner defending themselves. Be careful when you see this kind of argument being used against you, because the person making the argument is trying to throw you off track. And also make sure you don't use it yourself in your essays. That's it for logical fallacies. I hope this video has given you a better understanding of what the logical fallacies are and why to avoid them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.